Welcome to another episode of 666.
This place is a mess.
It's the upside down
version.
Look at
this dead land.
Look at this dead land as you try to click on anything and nothing is clickable. You're just like...
There are piles of crap everywhere. R2, turn off the trash compactor. Man, this place is a mess. It's so messy. I don't know where to start.
What about the angle? Let's deal with the fact that you guys are literally standing... you guys are laying on the floor and looking up at me and talking.
Magic.
Some of this crap looks familiar. I think a lot of these parts are of the puzzles we've solved in other rooms.
If that's true, then...
Wait, when did your bracelet turn red?
Has it been red ever since, he was found?
Maybe. Did he just get a whole new outfit?
Maybe.
Did someone just come by and was like, all right, I got this thing in the side corner over here that's for when Snake gets kidnapped. That's going to happen at like probably about 9 p.m.
It's been a little while. What bracelet did Snake wake up with? Was it still just two?
Yeah, he still has just regular
two. But it's just red now.
But it's just red now. It matches.
It just goes with his outfit.
Yeah, it just goes with his outfit? And yeah. Zero somehow planned that was like, well, somebody's going to wear this cloak and they got to look fly as fuck with that red watch. Like, ain't nobody be on my ship with unmatching colors. Because he dressed everybody else.
If I'm going to set this guy up in a revenge murder robe, it's going to look great.
Yeah. Well, I mean, like, everyone else was dressed by him.
Were they?
Yeah, Seven was. Seven's not a dock worker.
That's not everyone else, though. We have no other examples.
I'm assuming everyone else was... I mean, Three was obviously dressed by Zero. Because he is Zero! Oh! Okay, I'll stop.
I had to remind myself who we were talking about. Mostly because I don't... think about their numbers often enough. Oh. So like when you refer to them by the number, I'm like, that was... I mean, presumably Lotus wasn't dressed by him because Lotus explains her costume.
Yeah, that is kind of weird. Why did Seven get dressed in a fucking dock worker outfit?
Because copnesia.
What are you like? You got amnesia, woke up, was naked, dressed in a dock worker uniform?
Copnesia.
Lotus
it's
was
a common plot device.
Lotus was like clothed, woke up, and took
you
off
just don't
clothes.
Understand because you don't like anime.
I mean, at least anime is consistent. They just make them wear the same outfit every episode.
Mm-hmm.
I don't have to guess where they got those clothes from because I know where they got them from. They got them drawn on them.
What?
This room should be Zero's laboratory. Perhaps Zero would shut himself in this room to devise the machines and puzzles he'd need to solve to see his plan come to fruition.
Red thing.
There's like a lot of them. They're on the floor, they're on the wall. There's a blueprint board. Oh, it's a map.
Is that the solution to the puzzle we did?
Yes.
Is it?
No.
I remember this part. I don't remember this part quite. I don't remember going to California or coming from California.
Yeah, we didn't go to California.
But I feel like
We had to go from Japan
like
to New York.
Part. Yeah, but just not that arrow. That's a weird detail. Hey, Junpei, isn't this the nautical mat table? Yeah, I feel like I've seen this before. We're just gonna take it. It's ours now. Let's take random shit. A drafting table. Looks like it's been used quite a bit.
So I want to point out
fantasy
that
football.
Theoretically, this is Zero's laboratory that he turned into an escape room.
Sure.
So he like has a room that he does. That
Listen,
he,
you don't understand. It's meta.
Like he figured out how to do traps in this room, and then was like, "I got an idea.
What
Make
if this, was
this
trap?
Room a trap room."
Yeah. Like,
okay.
I'm just more concerned about how in the world they're doing this in like an hour.
Look, Keith.
They have time for two escape rooms? They were reading through a library earlier.
I think those fans are for ventilation.
On a ship?
They're probably there to circulate the air.
I'm just saying.
On
like,
a ship?
Yeah, I think so.
I mean.
Especially if you're working with fumes and stuff like that, you're going to want to circulate air in this room in particular, too. But I'm just saying that there's some Spielbergian time passage going on in this game. Like, time moves super fast when they're just talking in a room. When we used up an hour and a half all in one go.
Yeah.
But then now it's like we have time for all this shit. Also, your phone's making noise, you monster. So go deal with that.
Is it?
Yeah. It went up. Ding. There's nothing useful here. Ooh. Widgets and shit. There's a control panel in front of the big screen here. Wonder if any of these buttons do anything. I don't know. Let's press them all. There's something in the screen now. What's this? There are 15 cells here, with numbers and letters in them.
Let me see that. Ah, I see. So, whenever you touch a cell, the ones next to it turn on or off.
Oh, it's your favorite puzzle, Andrew.
You just gotta use that to make all cells on the right and the bottom green.
Hey, Junpei. I found this piece of paper under that thing. You want to take a look at it? Do you think this might have something to do with the puzzle? It's a piece of paper Clover gave me. Thanks. There are a bunch of numbers and letters connected by equal signs on it. Just like she said, it probably related to the puzzle on the screen somehow. Thanks, Clover. This really helps.
What?
Alright, let's go back and try again. We never tried. Oh, anyway, it looks like I'll just need to make all the panels in this. Make all of the cells all green.
Why is it like that? Why is it written like that?
It's in quotes and it's capitalized.
Yeah, but it makes no sense when you read it.
I know.
Oh, because it spells all.
Oh, all.
So what's the hint?
That's why it's in quotes.
Ah. Yes? Oh, it's the fucking base.
Hey, look, that's convenient.
Why didn't we have that before?
That's so convenient. But by the time you're this late in the game, you would have written this down probably already, yeah. Like we did. So it's not as useful anymore. But like, this is a weird choice. But hey, can I just keep this forever?
Like, yeah, theoretically, it's in your notes now.
Okay, so if I click on this, what happens?
Yes. Yeah, what? What?
Oh, 1 plus 9 equals A.
Yeah. But so how do you get the A up top? Do you get another?
6 plus 4 equals A. What's L? 21. F plus 1 plus 5. So basically just something in here. Probably the B needs to be turned off. I would say 9 plus C.
B is 11.
C is 12. So 9 plus C is 21. So the B is the thing that needs to be removed here. 6 plus F. F is 15. Yeah. So the B needs to be turned off. So we need to turn on everything except for the B and whatever the top left corner was.
Okay.
And I suck at these puzzles. Hooray.
Wait. What?
It's one of these. Like Momokuri. Remember your nemesis puzzle that you hate?
What?
That you loved so much?
You know, look. I want to point this out. This isn't...
People keep making this puzzle.
This isn't actually a fun
puzzle. I don't
like
it, but they keep making it.
This is not actually... What?
Yeah, I need to figure out how to turn off only that
one.
Can
you click the D off? This is one of those times where it's like, why can't I just click the thing? You know? What would really impact the
morphogenic fields, Andrew. Morphogenic fields.
Yeah, don't we already have access to the morphogenic field? Why can't we just figure the solution out?
Via magic. I'm really bad at these puzzles.
It's because it's just, you've got to just keep clicking to win.
I keep getting so close. I just need to get that over there. I just don't.
So what? I can't even follow, like, how to turn that off. To help you, I can't even follow it.
What can't you follow? How it works or just how to figure out how to do the Rubik's Cube style algorithm
both?
That's involved?
I can't even... I just... These puzzles are just so mind-numbingly stupid to me. Like, just click D, click B. Get them off.
You understand the mechanic, right?
No. I don't even understand the mechanic of this. Like, how...
So if I click on one, what's going to happen?
One turns off?
And?
The other three touching it?
Yeah. That's it. So you just have to figure out the Rubik's Cube style algorithm that goes into doing it, which I've never learned. I also don't know how to do Rubik's Cubes.
So if, wait.
So I kind of just push it for a while.
No,
and slowly go towards some semblance of progress. So it's so close.
Can't you
just
do...
This one needs to be turned off.
It's the three. Press the one. Press the one again.
You realize that's just going to... It's a binary state. If you press one thing twice, it goes back to where it was.
How do you not have Oh, F. So press... Oh, no, because F... Wait, what?
This has to be off, and this has to be off.
Yeah, but you can't...
We don't need to look at what's on them anymore.
You can't do that.
You probably can. It's just really time-consuming.
Well, that turns B back on, but you need F on as well. So you need to turn 5 off? So wait, turn... Ah, God.
Yep.
Okay, so... No. Fuck. Yeah, I can't do this while you're doing it.
Well, I know that.
This is just like incredibly...
I'm just trying to solve it.
Hard.
This has got to be thrilling video content.
It's not.
I'm so bad at this thing. You were literally, I think you were screaming at the screen when you first encountered this puzzle.
Yeah, because it's
on
stupid.
Our channel. It was in a game called, on Xbox Live, in a game called Mo Mercury 3, where the entire game was just this over and over again. Hey, I turned the mole on, which is usually the solution.
Yeah.
That's what I'm used to doing. I don't think I've ever done one where you have to turn on, where two specific ones have to be off. You either have to turn them all on or all off, usually, and that's what I've normally done in every game ever. Now they're all off. Ta-da!
There you go.
Let's see. Is there a clever sequence I can do that'll only turn on the ones I want? Probably not.
Hmm.
Hello, darkness, my old friend. Come to speak with you again. Are you trying to look it up or something?
Yeah, I'm just going to look it up. We already know the solution. Ah.
Getting ads.
We already know the solution, so what does it matter?
I would be very surprised if somebody actually wrote down a solution for this, because it's a sequence puzzle. That's just a huge pain in the ass to write a solution for it. These are just bad things to put in your puzzle game for the same reason sliding block puzzles and Rubik's Cubes are bad to put in your puzzle game, just because they're like... It's first of all, it's a derivative puzzle, so like you either... If you've solved it before, you already know how to solve it forever, basically. If you've learned how to solve it, I mean, not just fumbled through it. But it's also like, it's not contextual. It doesn't rely on the environment or, like, what you've observed about how to play the game. Like, it just comes out of nowhere in the middle of a playthrough. And that was the biggest bummer about playing Cube Escape. I played through all the Cube Escape games, and I played through Rusty Lake games, and I played through whatever recent game I played that was vaguely Myst-like. And in all those games' cases, eventually there would be a sliding block puzzle.
It's just something people like to put in because it pads for time.
Yeah, and it's like, oh, look, it's the thing that took no effort to make because it works the same way as every game ever, but it's just going to... It's like I'm never happy to see them. I'm never satisfied when I solve them either. Got it.
Oh, okay.
There we go.
I just found the solution.
You did it, Junpei.
Yeah.
You're so smart.
I just got done watching the solution, too.
You seem to have done an excellent job and solved the puzzle. Just what I would have expected of you, Junpei.
Hey, come on. You're embarrassing me.
Whoa, whoa. Don't get cocky, kid. We don't got time for that. Look at this. Check out the right edge of the control panel. The lid slid open and something came out.
By the way, like, as a general reaction, when that thing comes up, if I'm told, hey, you have an hour to live or you're going to explode horribly, and then I walk into a fucking Momocure or sliding block puzzle, I'm like, fuck, this is it. I lose. I'm going to die now.
I...
cross emblem. Metal plate shaped like a shield. There's a cross engraved in it. Hooray.
Great. What a fucking shitty ass.
Here's hoping that mechanic never shows up again. Hello, wall.
Alright, what else we got?
That's a pipe. There's a cabinet underneath it.
Okay.
Hello.
Hello.
The numbers again. All of them. again. There's a piece of paper in here. Not sure without taking a closer look, but I think it might be a clue. Junpei, we don't need this anymore, do we? No, I don't think so. Yeah, this is for a puzzle we already solved.
Oh my god, are you fucking kidding me?
Really?
Tell me more about this fucking object we just found. Which one would it be?
I don't know. How would you tell?
Search? Press A to search?
A is... that's just clicking on things.
God damn it!
It's a mistranslation, like, hint.
Go down? Or go to the next page? Go to 9-panel cross puzzle. Oh. This helps nothing. This just explains how the puzzle works.
Since it says first draft, then presumably it was improved upon on the second draft, and third, and so on. It's just an explanation of how to solve it, which we already knew. That was the easy part. The easy part was figuring out what configuration was the solution. The hard part was solving the whatever the reversal puzzles are called. There's a whole buttload of drawers in this cabinet.
I'm gonna open none of them.
I gave up the first one.
Excuse me, I want to see the literal Japanese translation and see if it actually says buttload.
I don't know. Isn't there an actual answer for what a buttload is, though?
Like, an actual numerical value for
a buttload? I think a buttload is actually a specific measurement now.
I will check this up because I don't believe you.
Yeah, these fans must be for ventilation. I can see walls on the other side of them. They're metal bars in front of the fan openings. I don't think we can get out that way. You probably wouldn't want to anyway, because you wouldn't end up where you're trying to go.
Wait, what?
What? This monitor is part of that machine. It's really dim, though. It's got a map of the world on it, but I can barely see it. Oh, he just stops there. He stops talking. It's a sliding panel, just like the last one. I wonder if there's a plate with an emblem engraved on it here.
So, there is apparently... So a buttload is a regional English measure of capacity of a heavy cart, a butt, containing 6 seams or 48 bushels. Or bushels.
We're learning things.
So a buttload would be a cart filled with 6 seams. So butt has nothing to do with it. Load is what everything has to do with it. Butt is just cart.
It's just a load that's in a butt.
Yeah.
Junpei, there's a wheel over here. Ah, that should work like the steering wheel. Sterling? No, I'm too poor for that. Stealing? That might solve my money problems, but I'd rather not. Oh, right. You were in the chart room, weren't you? What the fuck's happening?
So, this is another translation error where, like, one word in Japanese sounds like multiple words.
Yeah.
So she's just like, what? Like, stealing? No, you fucking idiot. I said it with clear English.
Because the quirk is that in Japanese, one word can literally be several different words.
Yeah.
But the translation is not that, so they have to make up a... I can't quite hear you, so I'm going to swap
now,
a letter.
Take your fucking mufflers off!
Yeah, she is wearing freaking headphones at all times. What?
What? Snake's dead?
Snake's dead?
I thought he's standing right here.
I thought you were Snake.
God.
There was a puzzle like this in the wheelhouse. I can figure out how this one works just by looking at that compass. I figure this thing will work like that other one. The other one? The important part is the nautical table we just found. I just have to match it up with the directions of the compass, with the lines and the nautical table. I used the steering wheel in the wheelhouse, but this time I think it's got to be... I'm going to use the wheel attached to the side here. Okay, then show me. Now! Of course.
That's the only way we can live.
Maybe I had to run through the instructions. No. This looks like it probably worked the same way as the steering wheel in the wheelhouse did that we just did, like really recently. If I touch the direction I want to turn to, the compass will turn that direction. Then I just got to press stop when the compass is pointing where I want it to. I'm betting something will happen if I can do it right. All right, let's do this. Here we go. So first we got to go south.
God. Then
now I've got to go west.
Wow, this is so fun.
Now I've got to go southeast, which is that away. Got to remember to press it early so that it stops on the right one. There we go. Now I got to go northeast.
Just keep turning it again.
Which is that away. Now I got to go east.
Beasties?
Yeah.
It's my favorite band.
Now I go north. The Easties boys.
The Easties boys.
Can't stand it. I have something. I'm your water gate.
Wait, did you just go west?
Yeah.
Why'd you go
Shit.
West?
Shit. No.
Well, we got to back out and do it again.
I've made a terrible mistake. Something's clicking, 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 clicking. Oh.
Oh my god. Are you fucking kidding me?
I made a mistake. And everyone else has to pay for it.
I...
Okay. Back to west again.
This fucking game, man. This game!
Is it bothering you that the puzzle is tedious, or that it's easy, or that we already did it before twice?
All three!
Because in that room, we did the same puzzle, like, twice in a row.
Ugh.
And then it's like, what if we use it again later? I can't wait for the next room where we literally do a sliding block puzzle.
We do a sliding block puzzle that requires us to move based on a compass location. But it's base 10. But it also requires us to match books in the right direction.
Ding, ding, ding. Yay, you did it, Junpei. Good boy. Who's a good boy? Oh, knock it off.
Hey, we don't have time for screwing around right now.
That's his primary dialogue right now, and I agree.
Check out the right side of the monitor. It just kind of slid open and something came out.
Oh, yeah. I heard a noise, too. You know that big box in the hall by the exit? I think it made a noise. Like something unlocking, you know? I don't think I even found the exit yet, to be honest. A noise, huh?
Yeah, you haven't found an exit.
Yeah, I don't know the box by the exit, because the first two things I clicked on were puzzles. And I'm like, I guess I'll solve it. Because yeah, until now, it's mostly been like adventure game puzzles, where pick up thing, find where thing goes, and stuff like that. Or how do these things interact? But this one's like a series of just individual puzzles, which kind of started ever since we encountered the Sokoban puzzle, where it was the sliding... Right, that was a sliding block puzzle. not what I was thinking of, though. Sokoban's better than sliding block puzzles. I guess I'm thinking of tile sliding puzzles is what I'm complaining about, actually. I hate tile sliders. Where it's like, it's a grid of like 25 tiles and one of them's missing, so you have to rearrange all of them to make the picture the right way.
The shit you give kids on a car trip so they just don't ever talk for the next lifetime.
I don't mind sliding block puzzles as much, because they're actually can be interesting, because there's more mechanics involved at times. I mean, fucking Steven Sausage Roll was literally just that for the entire its duration, and it was great.
Oh my god, how many fucking...
Let's see what happens when I... Whoa! Well, now we've got something on the screen, at least. Huh? What is this? Oh, wait a minute. I saw something like this when I figured out that Morse code puzzle back in the communications office.
Morse code?
Yeah. The dots on here look like dits for Morse code.
You're a ditz.
Feeling a little ditzy right now, Junpei? There's two dots on the first line. Four on the second, one on the last.
Oh, I'm afraid I don't understand. Well, perhaps you should give it a shot anyway.
All right, I'll try. Before I do that, though, maybe I ought to run through the instructions. If I tap the button, it'll enter a dit. Apparently, that's really what they're called. Okay. If I hold the button down, it'll enter a da. A do, 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 a da, da, da. That's all I wanna say to you.
It's like,
once we enter our answer, it'll automatically determine if it was the correct answer or not. All right, let's do this.
Wait,
Shit.
What? There's no hint
2-4-1,
button?
2-4-1, I think. Oh, wait. Oh, wait, it went to the next line?
Yeah.
Shit. What?
Reset this puzzle?
What?
Oh,
there must be somewhere else where we can find out the combination. Because the screen said, No, look at the screen.
Oh. No!
Look at... Show me what the screen said. Isn't that the...
Can you go to the menu?
Frustrating. As far as I could tell, the screen, it was 241, right? Or 242?
Yeah.
Was it 241?
241.
So I think something around here must tell us which ones are supposed to be dots and which ones are supposed to be bars.
Probably.
And so we need to find that paper somewhere. Because right now it tells us nothing. Ah! Well, now I know where these guys go. Let's just drop the emblem of the steering wheel in here. Sounds. Whoa! Well, now I've got something on the monitors at least.
What? What's that?
Looks like some kind of puzzle. I wonder if these are the rules. Here, I'll read them to you.
Ooh, bubble bop.
Bubble bobble?
Bust a move.
Bust a move, yeah. When you touch the numbered area, that area will be selected, and it will turn blue to indicate this. Touching a numbered ball after selecting an area will cause the ball to be moved to that area. However, you cannot move the red balls. You can only move 3 to 5 balls into a single area. This is Digital Roots.
Yeah.
Again. Press the check button once you have moved all the balls except for the red ones, which you cannot move.
So 9?
The digital root of the balls in the area must match the number for the area. That's it. So what's going on here is that this area is... It's the workshop where all the puzzles are designed, which is their excuse for why every puzzle is going to be puzzles we've already done before.
Nice try.
For the entire place.
Except he made it a puzzle room.
Including now we're doing a Nonary game puzzle room. I still don't really get it. Really, Junpei? You don't get the thing that is the entire reason you're alive right now is understanding this mechanic? That's how the Nonary games work?
It's okay, Junpei.
Whatever. Like they say, practice makes perfect. Prefects. Let's give
Wait,
it a shot.
Wait, what? Practice makes prefects?
Yeah. Percy Weasley.
Percy? You mean...
You don't remember.
The son of Poseidon?
You don't know. You don't care about Harry Potter. Don't. That's you.
Don't you mean practice makes perfect?
Hey, let's see you solve the next one. Then you can make fun of me, blind man.
Junpei, what the fuck?
Shots
They're all visual related
people.
Puzzles. Like, what kind of asshole are you? He can't see the puzzles.
Even though he literally can just say what the numbers are and be like, we gotta match them into digital roots 6 and 3. That's the puzzle.
There's no hint for this one. I can't
no.
just look at my watch to well, be remembered that I did this the entire game.
Yeah, I was going to be like, what do you mean hint? Like, this is what we've been playing the entire game.
So
we need to match up with 6 and 3, and it has to be 3 to 5, which means it's not super common to be able to put them in a... Like, you can technically do, like, 1, 2, 3 in the same one. And that'd be 6. So our goal here would be to get to 12 with 3 of them or less.
No, all
Which
the balls have to
be possible.
Moved, except for 9.
Oh, they did say we have to use every
yeah,
single
Yeah, we have
one.
To use every ball.
That does make it harder. Okay, so maybe 21. Time for lots
so
of
you could
math.
Throw you could throw 8 into 6, and that would still make the digital root of 6?
No.
No?
No, it wouldn't.
Oh, you have to throw... Oh, wait, 9, sorry. You can't move 9.
Yeah, you can only... if you've already added stuff up to being a digital root of something, the only way to add numbers to it and keep it the same digital root is to add a multiple of 9 to it.
Whack!
Yep.
Can you move the 9?
They said you can't move the red ones.
Okay.
You cannot use this number!
So...
Oh, we're fine. I said we need to add up to 21. Let's see, 6, 7, 8. That's just 3. That's just 7 times 3, and 7 times 3.
Or you could do
21.
8, 7, 6.
Burp, 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 burp.
No.
Did I not beat it?
No. That's 8, 7, 6 adds up to 21.
8, 7, 6 is 21. Then 5 plus 4 would be. That's just 9, so shouldn't it still have the same digital root of 3?
No.
21 plus 5 and 4 makes the digital root 30, which is 3.
No. Do check then. Maybe the red... Oh, maybe the red just meant it's full.
It was just... Oh! It's red because we had 5. Yeah, I was like, no, that should be completely right. Okay, this is right? But nothing's happening.
There are still 3 more indentations left empty. I imagine something will happen when they're all filled. Doesn't that seem likely?
Alright, put another one in, Junpei.
Okay, let's put the emblem of the cross.
Hey, Junpei, something just showed up on the screen.
This puzzle sure looks a lot like the last one.
Yeah,
but shots fired at game by game script.
Yeah, but there's more of those red balls you can't move.
So it's easier?
It's harder.
It seems easier because there's fewer options. The numbers for each area are different too.
It looks like it's got the same rules as the last one though.
The Nonary game?
Yeah.
You sure you don't want to double check that?
No, I'll be fine. If I get confused, I can just look at the screen over there, right? Anyway, like they say, a picture is worth 1,000 awards. Okay. Let's give it a shot. Jokes!
Isn't that a picture is worth 1,000 words?
Don't worry, game. If you do this joke another 20 times, it'll become funny.
If it does it, well, it has 2 more times.
Hey,
to get it right.
Shut it! At least I'm trying, alright? But yeah,
is
stop.
Junpei trying to, like, ease the mood by being a complete idiot? That's not really reassuring when you're relying on him to do the puzzle to get you guys to not die.
It's not
like a bitch is worth 1,000 words, guys. And it's like, Junpei, please.
Ward.
Like, we're gonna die. Could you not?
Ward.
Ward.
Okay. Time to think of different combinations.
Oh,
it's all the fun of figuring out nonary explanations without the primary reason we do it, which is that there's story stuff to theorize about. Let's see.
Things okay, well, work. This is easy. Just put a 6 in the 1, and then put a 4 in the 7, and they equal each other.
What? You're just saying nonsense?
No. Let's see.
Wait, you were, like, trying to switch their places and become 7 and 1 for some reason? I'm like, what are you going for here? I don't understand. Let's see.
So 8 and 3, right? Oh. I was gonna
Which
say
one
are
you thinking of?
I was going to say just get to 11, so 8 and 3. Oh, no, need to get to 10, so 8 and 2.
Yeah, 8 and 2, and then 4 and 5 is also 9, so yeah. I literally just went up to 7 by putting 7, and then did 8 and 2 for 10, and then just added 9 to each, because that makes it even. Ta-da! Because if you add 9, it never affects the digital route.
That's right.
That's awesome, Junpei! There's only 2 left now. You can do it.
Thanks or for we all the help, to... room full of people. Yeah. Or hey, here's an idea. Maybe the team of 4 people should split up and solve the 4 puzzles independently instead of just fucking watching me
Again. During
our last hour of life.
One person is blind.
Fine. One person can solve 2 of them, which I did already. What's the excuse now? There's 4 people in this room and 4 puzzles, and we're all going to die in, like, 20 minutes. Like,
well,
we are so close to dying.
We just
right got to
rely on the guy who can't even speak English.
They said we were going to die in 90 minutes or something like that, or an hour. Like, fucking, like, it's an escape room and several flashbacks and dialogue screens ago. And, oh, God, what is this? This metal shutter looks pretty sturdy. It's framed with black and yellow warning stripes.
That's racist.
All right, let's open it. Oh, holy shit. That's pretty damn creepy. There's a coffin in here. How many coffins are there?
Hey, that coffin says all ice on it.
It does say all ice on it. Is this finally the one? Because we found 3 of them now. But this one, oh yeah, right. Because yeah, the story said that she was going to be in the room behind the Forest of Knowledge.
Yeah.
So we're finally in the room that Alice is supposed to be in. It is weird that it's our third weird, identical, airtight wooden coffin, though.
But this one doesn't have a keypad on it.
No, or we can't see its profile yet. There's a coffin in there. A coffin. Oh, man. Does 7 think... Yeah, he's all pale.
Man.
He's
Junpei.
Thinking the same thing I am.
I guess Junpei has a cold. Do you hear him? He's
what?
Like, a coffin.
Stop making the jokes the game makes. I can't take it anymore.
Wake me up! No way. Could this be...
Because he told us the story.
I'm sorry, but what's going on?
There's another snake.
Sorry, man, I'm just a little blind.
You must be Solid Snake, and inside there must be Liquid Snake.
I'm gonna take his arm.
It's a coffin. I wonder if there's a vampire in it.
Yeah, like 7?
Right. I guess Clover and Snake don't know the story.
Snake?
Man, yeah. I can't bring myself to tell them.
What? You can't bring yourself to tell them there might be just a mummy in there?
Wake me up.
Well, at any rate, let's have a look around.
So, open it.
There's a metal plaque on the coffin. Snake's touching it.
All ice. Ah, the two machines.
Gulp? Holy shit.
Who's gulping?
I guess me, because there's no name. Man, this is serious.
Oh, well, let's open it, shall we? Clover, if you could give me a hand. Get it?
Okay.
Because I only have one.
I got it.
Ready? 3, 2, 1. Huh.
Oh.
No luck. It doesn't seem to be ready to open.
Yeah, but it's not like it's screwed shut or something.
Yes, I believe it's locked in some other way.
Hey, Seven, do you think you could open up with your superhuman strength?
No, I...
What's wrong?
I think I'll just pass on this one, okay?
What the heck?
Very well. We'll have to give up on the coffin for now. Let's look around the room a little more, shall we?
Alice sleeps in a small chamber past the Forest of Knowledge beneath the navel of the Gigantic. Is that actually true?
That's silly. Ships don't have belly buttons.
I'm more bothered by how they're just dropping the subject.
Yeah.
It's like, you're going to die. Everyone is going to die if you can't solve this room. And Snake's like, nah, I won't try to open it. Fucking, you're not going to even, like, follow up on that a little bit? Like, you're just completely
unfazed. Why does it matter? Worst case scenario, you open it up.
Why are we closing it?
Yeah, I don't know. Worst case scenario, Seven, you open it up and there's a frozen girl inside.
The game constantly makes you reclose everything you open because all the pre-rendered scenes are only animated that way.
Yeah.
I noticed that because I played through Mist and Riven recently. And that happens constantly. Except in those games, those games have really elaborate, long-ass, like, drawn-out animations for opening and closing stuff, and they play every single time you leave something open because it has to close so that all the printed scenes have it closed again.
Delightful!
Hooray! A steel cabinet with a double door.
Okay. So, is there any other... there has to be one more puzzle, right?
Yeah, somewhere.
Somewhere!